Is it just a myth that you have to change motor oil once a year, even if it's low hours or low miles? Each year, lots of money is being spent on changing motor oil that has low hours, low miles, just because it's reached the 1 year mark. So today I've got two different samples of engine oil, one from 14 months of age and one from 17 months of age that we're gonna do some testing on. Additionally, we're gonna compare two full synthetic motor oils, Dello against Rotella T6. So let's get the testing underway. This is a 1996 Dodge Ram with the 5.9 Cummins and a P7100 injection pump. I last changed this oil almost a year and a half ago at 110,879 miles. It now has 114,017 miles, which is 3,138 miles since the last oil change. Now, in theory, what happens to the oil is it becomes acidic, and acid is going to cause corrosion. So we're gonna do some testing on this oil just to see if this oil is still good after 17 miles. I'm going to collect the oil midway through the drain cycle that we'll be using for additional testing, and we'll send some of this oil off to an oil testing lab. This style of filter wrench works fairly well on a lot of vehicles, but definitely not on this truck. I really like this little adapter that fits on the actual filter. This thing is terrific. If the oil filter is mounted horizontally, obviously you can't pre-fill the oil filter, but if it's mounted vertically, you can. I'm going with the Shell Rotella T6 for now. I haven't had a chance to test the Dello, and I want to go ahead and use up the T6 I've got and before I consider switching over to the other brand. In theory, if the used oil has become corrosive, we might actually see some form of corrosion on the inside of this oil filter. So I'm going to go ahead and open it up and we'll take a closer look. I don't see any sort of rust or corrosion inside this oil filter, so it does not appear that the oil has become corrosive. Look at the wire mesh inside this Fleet Guard filter. I don't see any sort of large debris getting through this filter. Very impressive. I'm gonna go ahead and squeeze the filter media out in the vise and we'll take a closer look at it. The filter media from the Dodge 2500 Cummins. The filter media looks really clean. I just changed the oil and I pre-filled the oil filter, so let's see how long it takes for this oil pressure to reach about 40 psi. This is the oil from the Dodge Ram we just drained out. I'm gonna send this off to the lab. I always shake oil containers before sending off samples for testing, since part of the additive package may actually fall out of suspension and settle at the bottom of the container. This is the oil drained out of the Ford 5000 tractor from a previous video in which we tested whether or not synthetic oil causes engine oil leaks. This oil was in the engine for 14 months. We'll also send it off to the oil testing lab for analysis. Before we begin the next test, I'll add the 14-month-old T4 oil from the Ford 5000 tractor, the 17-month-old T4 oil from the Dodge Cummins, and new Rotella T4 to the cold oil flow tester. I'll place the oil in a freezer that's set to 40 below zero Fahrenheit, and we'll test cold oil performance later in the video. In the next test, we'll be comparing the lubricity or film strength of each product. We'll begin by adding 40 milliliters of oil of each product into the test cups. The test will last right at 10 minutes. After the test, we'll compare the size of the wear scars on each of the bearings to determine if the used oil from the Cummins is just as good as new oil that's only been exposed to heat. Used T4 out of the Cummins is on the left. The oil on the right is the new T4. Both of them did very well, virtually identical results, indicating that the film strength of the used oil is still good. New T4 is in lane 1, used oil from the Cummins is in lane 2, and used oil from the Ford 5000 is in lane 3. Oil from the Ford 5000 is out of the gate first, then the Cummins, then new T4. The Ford 5000 definitely has thinned out and is really flowing quickly, but the Cummins isn't too far behind. The new T4 seems pretty happy with third place. And oil from the Ford 5000 finishes first, Dodge Cummins second, and the new T4 finishes third. Ideally, the used oils would flow at nearly the same rate as the new oil. And the oil from the Cummins actually did a respectable job, while the Ford 5000 oil did flow a little too fast. Up next, we'll compare Rotella T6 with Dello 400. Shell Rotella T6 is a synthetic that's designed for extreme temperature. It's SAE 5W40. This oil is formulated for diesel engines. A lot of viewers have commented that they use this in their gasoline engines. Triple Protection Plus includes better fuel economy performance, excellent extreme high low temperature protection, and engineered to control turbocharger deposits. It meets API service CK4, CJ4, CI4 Plus, CI4, and CH4. This Chevron Dello full synthetic motor oil claims to provide up to 69% better wear protection compared to API CJ4 motor oil. The Shell Rotella T6 and the Dello oil are both SAE 5W40 motor oil. The Dello is also a heavy-duty diesel engine oil. The Shell Rotella T6 only included the diesel designation, but this Dello oil also includes the SN for gasoline engine use. I already have the oil testing lab results back on the Shell Rotella T6 from an earlier video that we did on T6, but I haven't yet tested the Dello. But I'm going to go ahead and send off the oil for analysis, and we'll come back to this later in the video. In the first test, we'll see which oil tolerates the heat the best. We'll first measure out 200 grams of oil into each of the oil containers, then expose them to 410 degrees Fahrenheit of heat for 2 hours. I'll rotate the oil containers every 10 minutes just in case one burner is hotter than the other. I'll also monitor the temperature of both oils throughout the test just to make sure that they're very close to the same. Both oils will experience an equal amount of time on each burner. So why this test? The NOAC volatility test exposes oil to even more heat than this test to simulate engine operating conditions around the upper piston ring area of an engine. High quality oils resist evaporation and thermal breakdown. At the end of this test, we'll compare both oils to see which oil experienced the most evaporative loss. Then we'll be using the cooked oil from this testing for 2 additional tests to see how they perform. It's been right at 2 hours. I'm going to go ahead and remove the oil from the burners and allow this oil to cool down. Once it's cooled off, we'll weigh each container to see how much evaporative loss occurred with each brand. Rotella T6 started out at weighing 430.13. It now weighs 423.71. That's a loss of 6.42 grams. Dello started off at weighing 411.29. It now weighs 402.84. That's a loss of 8.45 grams, so T6 experienced less evaporative loss than Dello. Since the oil needs to be in the freezer for 24 hours for the cold oil flow test, let's place both the new and the cooked oils in a freezer that's set to minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and we'll come back to this test later in the video. Let's find out if Dello 400 or Shell Rotella T6 offers the best protection against wear. We'll be testing both brands of oil that we just exposed to the heat. The test will last right at 10 minutes. While the Lubricity tester doesn't simulate engine operating conditions perfectly, it'll provide us with some great information. T6 is on the left and Dello is on the right. Both oils did very well in this showdown, with T6 coming out ahead with a 3% smaller wear scar than Dello. When it comes to selecting a high-quality motor oil, cold oil performance is a huge factor. Let's kick off the cold oil flow test and see how each oil flows when it's very cold. New T6 lane 1, cooked T6 lane 2, cooked Dello lane 3, new Dello lane 4. And new T6 is out of the gate first and cooked T6 in a very close second. New Dello is in third and cooked Dello is fourth. This is going to be a really close race with all the oils out of the gate quickly and moving fast. Team T6 is really on the move and Team Dello is trying to make up some ground, but T6 is hauling diesel down the straightaway. It's new T6 for the win, Cook T6 second, new Dello third, and Cook Dello fourth. What a great race by both teams. Very interesting results on the oil analysis reports. The Ford 5000 has a high copper and lead content as a result of using engine restore, which is not a problem. It also has a high level of silicon, but this doesn't have anything to do with the age of the oil. Instead of using a modern air filter, the Ford 5000 still has the oil bath system on it. Assuming that we still had a modern air filter on the tractor, the oil wouldn't have had this level of silicon. The viscosity of 70.9 is still within the normal range of 69 and 80. It also has less than 0.5% of fuel contamination, 0% antifreeze, 0% water, and 0.5% insolubles, which is still within the normal range, along with a very good total base number of 7.8. So what the TBN means is that the oil still has the ability to resist becoming acidic and is still in very good shape. Check out the wear metals on the Cummins. The oil did only have 3,200 miles on it, but the wear metal content in the oil is at a very good level, indicating that the oil is still doing a fine job. The detergency as well as the anti-wear levels are very good. The viscosity of the oil at 72.9 is still in the normal range, which is between 69 and 80. The fuel has less than 0.5% fuel contamination, 0% antifreeze, and 0% water, 0.1% insolubles, and a very strong TBN of 8.9. So the oil is definitely still good for probably at least another year or so, along with 3,000 more miles of use. So is T6 better than Dello? I've placed both oil analysis reports side by side so we can compare. Dello is on the left and T6 is on the right. T6 has 11% higher detergent dispersant content. Also, T6 has a 31% higher anti-wear additive package, which includes phosphorus and zinc. T6 also has a slightly higher TBN compared to Dello. So in my opinion, based upon my testing along with the oil labs information, T6 is a better oil. So does engine oil definitely go bad after just 12 months of time in a crankcase? Absolutely not, and in my opinion, it's a myth as long as you're making sure your engine reaches full operating temperature at least once a month. Now, if you're not allowing that engine to fully warm up, there is a great potential for moisture contamination, and that, of course, is a problem. As we saw in both the tractor and the Dodge truck, neither one of those oils had any sort of moisture contamination. Both of them had a very good TBN. So the oils are definitely still good in both of those well after a year of time in the crankcase. As usual, just want to say thanks so much for watching the video. I try to read and reply to as many comments as possible. So if you have a video idea, I'd really like to hear it. Until next time, please take care and I look forward to seeing you then.